Hi guys, in this video I'm going to add two USB power sockets to my Skoda Octavia facelift from 2010. Initially I wanted to put one of them here in the middle between the heated seat buttons that I added, but there is not enough room for them. They are have too big of a diameter, and honestly I don't think it would look good there in the end. So I decided on another thing. It will go somewhere around here, of course the other way around, like that. And it will look like this when looking at it. So it will be pretty good and it's in a decent position. Of course, this remains. I used until now USB power socket that plugged into here, but you had to put it out, take it out, put this back in. So it really wasn't a good solution, permanent solution. This is way, way better. And I just checked, it seems that I have enough space in here, really, really low at the bottom of this. A fly just entered the car. Great. Let me get it out, okay. And the other one I think I'm going to put in here. So I have USB power inside for a Bluetooth adapter that will be plugged in into the auxiliary input from the radio, so that is out of sight when it's closed. I cannot close it because it is already turned down a little bit. It will be out of the way. So let's do this. First thing, I need to drill a hole and put this in, and route some cables underneath this whole thing. I loosed it, made it loose in the back. Hopefully you can see. I took everything out, just four screws, and the rest clipped in place. And now I can lift it, so I have a bit of excess underneath. I don't want to take it all off. It's enough if I lift it a little bit. So yeah, let's do this. Finished the hole. I need to file it up a little bit because my biggest drill was 25 millimeters, and I think this is 26, 27, 28, something bigger. So in the end it fits. It has plenty of room behind it, so it doesn't actually hit this wall. You can see I didn't drill through it. So this is the perfect position. Next I'm going to route the cables up to here, and the second one will not be like I wanted here. There is not enough space behind it. The air vents are in the way, sadly, but there is enough space here. This area here is not occupied by anything. This, if you look at it, goes down like that. So everything that's above it, nothing ever goes there. This would go there if it would get to this point, like this, straight up almost. But if your handbrake gets to that point, you have a serious problem with your handbrake, so of course it will never go there. And even if it reaches that, if I put it somewhere around here, like this, it will still not hit it. So yeah, not too high, because there is about this much space used by the rails for this protection. So yeah, probably here will be my hole. And yeah, let's do that. For this hole, do not commit to it right from the start. Drill a pilot hole and feel from the other side to see where you are compared to the things inside. Mine is a bit wrong, so it needs to be about here, the middle of the hole. The height is correct, it's perfect, but the position is not right. So I will drill here, and the edge of my drill bit will be this tiny hole. Yeah, I will probably remain with a bit of a scratch here, but doesn't really care. Doesn't really matter, sorry. As you can imagine, it's very hard to make this hole. So I was able to cut about half of it with my drill, and the rest I need to break with all sort of stuff. And yeah, it all will not be perfect, but doesn't really matter because this thing has a lip on it, so it will not be seen. The other one is perfect. So yeah, I will continue until this thing fits, because at the moment it still doesn't fit. So I have a little bit more work to do. Hole finished. Not pretty, but it gets the job done. And now I can really check. This is the depth of the hole, my finger, almost all of it, so it's way bigger than this, as you can see. So absolutely no problems, we are no way near this, and nothing else. So we are good, we cleared everything. It is as high and as much to the left as it could have been. Of course, to the right it would have been closer to this, so I didn't want to risk that. So yeah, for me it's good. I'm going to solder some wires onto this, heat shrink them for insulation. Use heat shrink protection actually for insulation, and then route them through here. So let's do it. First one is ready to go in, soldered and insulated. And just make sure before you put the wire where you want it, you have to put to hold this with your hand on the other side and put the wire, the cable through it, because you want to tighten this on the back. This is the way you hold this thing in place, which is great, absolutely great. But yeah, keep it in mind, otherwise around you cannot put it there. So let's do it. First cable is routed. This thing is in position. It already has the nut, if you want to say, on the other side, so you cannot pull it out anymore. And let me just push it in its correct location. And of course I will align it properly when I tighten it from the back. Now it wants to stay a certain way. I don't care about that. I will put it the way I want it. And this should be it for the first one. So let's do this. Of course, I just want to show you the fact that this is loose. So you can lift it a bit, so you can put your hands underneath it to reach this area, and that area is really good. I don't want to take it all off, because as you can see, it is, I don't have any idea actually where it stops, maybe here. But I don't want to take this whole thing off. No way. It's enough that it's loose, so I can put my hands underneath it. It's in position and it's tightened. You cannot rotate it anymore, no matter what you try. And it's looking great. So yeah, I'm going to do the second one, then the wires, then clean up. I still have lots of work to do, but it's all worth it. All cables are routed and are ready for the heated seats and for the USB power source. And I'm going to take the ground from here, as you can see, directly from the chassis of the car. Two big bolts, then one bolt here. Welded here, and this is the point where I'm going to take the ground with this loop, two wires, and this. So let's do it. Ground is finished. I used this electrical tape here just to make sure that the wires above it cannot get cut by the thread of the screw. It was not really needed, but I wanted just to make sure.
this to relieve some tension from the solder, from the wires, and yeah, then they go down and pop up right here and go right to the heated seat from the right side and to this USB socket. On the other side, the second cable, direct connection, heated seat from there, and the other socket right there. And now I just have to bring 12 volt to these points, this and this, with this cable and through this 10 amp fuses, and for the USB sockets in series there are 2-3 amp fuses, because I don't think if something happens to that they can blow these 10 amp fuses, so I wanted smaller ones in series. And I don't want to bring 4 wires all the way from the main fuse box. So yeah, let's do this. Getting ready to tap into the main fuse box. I used this kind of wire termination and I soldered it to the wire, insulated with heat shrink tube, and soldered into the middle hole, because I a normal fuse doesn't have that hole and I didn't want to upset something there, something not making good contact because of that hole. They don't want to take any chances. So this will be one of the fuses. Let me just show you. Okay, hard to open with one hand. Really hard to open with one hand. Next to impossible. But I'm not giving up. Just bump that thing down. Standard fuse. I could have put this fuse in my main fuse box, but that would mean to open up a lot in that area and take out my fuse box, because the second contact is missing from all the unused spaces, so way more complicated than just tapping into it like this. You'll see in a moment how I will do it. To route wires through where you want them, use a thicker monofilament wire. This stays like you bend it. Multifilament wires do not. And use electrical tape to fix your wires to that one, and when you pull this one, you will pull yours where you want them. So yeah, let's do this. Where your wires have a chance to rub against the metal frame, use electrical tape to mask the edges, to cover them, so you do not create a fire hazard or continuously blow up your fuses. So yeah, better it doesn't look that great, although this is absolutely covered, but when you look at the fuses you can see that, but it's 100% safe. I go for safe every single time. Okay guys, so I'm searching for fuses that have power only when the contact is on. Here everything is finished, but I didn't put on the panels because I want to test everything before closing it up. So I found two variants here. On left and right of this 15 amp fuse, this one's here. That seems to be only when the contact is on, they have power, so that is good. And three of them here, but I don't really like that positioning. Here seems to be better for me. So yeah, let's do this. And of course, let me just show you something one moment.
I'm using this listing on eBay to see where the wires are thicker. So here the wires seem to be really thick. Of course, this fuse box is for the right-hand drive version of this car, so it's 100% mirrored from what we have here. Although my camera cannot do this thing. You see ours now, and then you see this one. They are mirrored. But yeah, the ideal position is here because there are really thick wires behind, bringing power there. So yeah, let's do this. Okay, this is done. I'm really happy how my fuses stay here. This is, as you can see, really strong connection. So let's give them a quick test. Okay, quick first test. They seem to be working without any issues, both of them. The wires are connected to the wires that are coming here for my heated seats. If you want to see more about the wires connection, check out my video where I install my heated seats. And yeah, a separate video will be showing how I connect my Bluetooth receiver, audio receiver, to my car. And yeah, hopefully next in this video everything will be put back together and we see how this thing charges my phone. Okay guys, this is finished, 100% working. When the contact of the car is off, hopefully you can see it is actually off. Let me just put the contact, and it is on. So yeah, looks pretty decent. You are, from my position, you are not even able to see it when I'm driving. The second one is here, and yeah, I will put my USB stick for the auxiliary audio input and listen to music from my phone, and this will all be out of sight and it will start by itself when I start the car, which is great. So yeah, if you have any questions, feel free to ask them in the comments. Like, subscribe, check out my other videos, and see you again next time. Bye.